So I got this pocket microscope to help with a photography project that I've been working on. Unfortunately, it didn't turn out as planned. Yet, the Carson MP-250 was a fun gadget, so that qualifies as a video in the Photics TV fun playlist. This microscope is featured on the Carson website as education on the go. I think that's the most appropriate use of this pocket microscope. It's quite portable, and it's something of an entry-level microscope. Perhaps you're homeschooling and you need a cheap microscope. This was only $20 at Amazon.com, which was nice. Obviously, there's more expensive gear that can do a much better job, but I tried to save money by going with this inexpensive gadget. While it didn't accomplish my primary objective, I don't regret the purchase, as this thing is amazing. How is it doing 250 times magnification at only $20? It can't be real, right? It is indeed for real. It does work. I was able to create digital images at the microscopic level. That's what's so neat about the Carson MP250. It comes with a clip so that a smartphone can be attached to the microscope. However, the first tip is that you might need to detach your case. I tried it with my iPhone SE 2nd edition, and the smartish case was getting in the way, so I removed it. That's another tip. Be careful. This setup is a little awkward. I dropped 2 iPhones while creating this video. Fortunately, no damage was done, but it's definitely a cautionary tale. The problem is that there are a few things to do to get a good picture. You have to balance the microscope and the smartphone while manually adjusting the focus and the zoom. But let's back up a bit. What's included in the box? On the left, there's the smartphone clip, which is the primary reason why I bought this device. I was looking for a quick and easy way to take microscopic images with my iPhone. A blank microscope slide was included, which is nice. That can really help with positioning your subject. While a 250 optical zoom might not seem like a lot when compared to microscopes that can zoom over 1,000 times, it's enough to amplify even the slightest of movements. There's the pocket microscope. It's pretty much the main attraction. I think that's what's nice, how it's just one piece. It was really easy to set up. In fact, it already had the wrist strap attached. I promptly removed that, as I'm not going to use that. It would only get in the way. There's a small instruction booklet. I barely glanced at it, although there is something important to know about this microscope. The battery is not included. It uses a single AA battery to power the LED light. What surprised me is that it also has a UV light. That kinda concerned me, as I can't see UV light. What am I supposed to do with this? The microscope does glow with a bluish light when the UV light is active. What's nice is that the UV light has to be held to be used. I thought that was a good idea. This is not the case with the main LED light, as it can be turned on or off with the press of a button. So the first object featured in this video is a United States quarter. I haven't used coins in such a long time that I forgot what they felt like. Were coins always this small? I picked up a penny and wondered if it was counterfeit. Anyway, this is a screen recording of a close-up of the quarter. The first thing you'll notice is a giant circle. It's a very iconic shape of using this microscope with a smartphone camera. But also, the image wasn't what I was expecting. What am I looking at here? The moon? This thing gets really close. You can get rid of the circle by zooming in your smartphone camera. Brilliant! It seems so obvious to put these two technologies together. Yet, this microscope was only $20! I remember as a kid wanting a microscope, but they weren't cheap. It was that influence from those Transformer cartoons. I saw a Perceptor, and I was like, I want that! However, that little toy just doesn't compare to the capability of this one. I suppose that is a bigger question. Is this a toy? I had trouble finding a practical use for it, as this field of view doesn't help me much. So, I tried again with a piece of romaine lettuce. It was from Costco, and I was impressed at how green their lettuce has been looking lately. Like it was somehow more bright. Would a closer examination reveal the secret? First, I started with a small piece of lettuce, roughly the size of the quarter from before. Again, it's the same story. Wow, it gets close. But again, I'm not sure if this is practical. It's kind of blurry and greenish. This is not my area of expertise, so I don't know if this is truly useful. As an example, I wanted to look at the brown spots on the lettuce leaf, so I tore off another piece and placed it under the microscope. I just couldn't get a good look at it. This is very tricky, as you have to aim. I was constantly sliding the iPhone camera ever so slightly in the clip. You have to think backwards. Pushing towards the right moves the image towards the left. I was having fun though, as I didn't know what to expect. I tried again with a strip of dried mango. I tore off a piece and took a closer look. Again, the view was similar to the lettuce leaf, except here the image was yellowish instead of greenish. That's because the LED light really floods the object with light. This is necessary to see the object, as the image is extremely dark without the LED light. It's not an insurmountable problem though. If you can keep the microscope and the camera extremely steady, you can use an app like Slow Shutter Cam to use natural light. This image is a close-up of the table. It looks like an alien planet. I tried again with a more familiar object, a banana. This time, I was trying to zoom in on one of the brown spots. This is what that looks like normally with the iPhone SE camera. And this is what that looks like with the Carson MP-250. Can you see a difference between this and the mango? Well, that leads to tip number three. One of the things I noticed is that dark circles were appearing while focusing. This emphasizes the importance of keeping the lenses clean. I suspect there was some dust between the microscope and the camera, as there is a fair amount of space between those lenses. Here's the banana again after cleaning the lenses. It looks better, but again, I'm not sure what I'm looking at here. I was able to get a look at the edge of a brown spot on the banana. I'd like to say that I had a scientific epiphany here, where I could use words like eureka, fascinating, or even interesting. Nope. I kept trying with another yellowy object. This time, it was a Milano cookie. Again, I had trouble telling these images apart. Can you spot the difference? Which one is the mango? Which one is the banana? And which one is the Milano cookie? That's when I tried something a bit more familiar to me. Since I have experience with printing, I decided to take a closer look at the microscope's box. That is pretty amazing, as what looks like a picture is just a bunch of dots. Cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. CMYK. That's certainly a useful lesson that can be shown with this pocket microscope. I also tried getting a close look at this American flag. What I saw was pretty impressive. I could see all the little threads woven together. Although, I'm still not quite sure what was the material. It looks so shiny that it makes me wonder if it's plastic. It certainly doesn't look like this. Any guesses as to what we're looking at now? It looks white and soft, like a puffy pillow or fluffy sweater. Nope, it's another American icon. It's a dollar bill. If you are homeschooling, or perhaps you just want to get more involved with your kids' education, this is a great experiment. The dollar bill is loaded with lots of wonders that can be revealed with a microscope. Out of all the items featured in this video, I think this is where the microscope excelled. I did try some other experiments though. In particular, I took a close look at a cat hair. Quite often, when talking about microscopic things, it's often compared to a human hair. So, just how big can this setup enlarge a hair? It's about that big. What do you think? Is that impressive? It is a little interesting, as I'm surprised at how the hair is not smooth. The side looks rigid. For the final experiment, I took a look at a solid-state drive. The idea was to get a close-up of electronics. It gets pretty close. One of the things that immediately confused me were the white blobs. I didn't know what that was. Do you know? It looked like a candy coating. Kinda like frosting. Like something you'd see on a donut. Eventually, I figured out that it was the letters. That's pretty impressive. Anyway, it's not bad for $20. I'm disappointed that I don't have a real use for this thing. The zoom is too strong for macro photography, but not strong or sharp enough for professional level microscopic photography. That sounds obvious though, it's not pro gear. I probably had too high of expectations for this gadget. Well, I suppose there was one very important use. I was able to make this nice video with it. For that, I think it's great. But what do you think? Do you like the Carson MP-250 pocket microscope? You can let everyone know in the comments. Thanks for watching.